Most icebergs are white, or they even appear blue. But did you know that there's such a thing as a green iceberg? These icebergs aren't just green, they are a beautiful shade of emerald green, and scientists and explorers have been transfixed by green icebergs in Antarctica since the 1900s. So what causes an iceberg to be green? Well, I'm gonna tell you in just a second, but first, the intro. Welcome back to InformOverload, the news channel for people who find CNN boring. I'm Charlotte Dobre, hit that subscribe for news updates that are actually interesting, hosted by people you might actually want to be friends with. Yes, people want to be my friend. Are you really that surprised? And don't forget to check out that description for the links to all our social media handles. Mysterious green icebergs have been puzzling scientists for many years. I mean, it's a green iceberg. Sure, Russia has green snow right now, but the two phenomenons are not correlated. The green snow in Russia is being caused by chemical pollution. And the green icebergs? Well, let's just say scientists finally think they know why they're green, and the reason is natural causes. No, the natural causes are not plant life. Scientists used to think that the green color was coming from dissolved marine plants and animals that died a long time ago, that floated around and got locked up in ice. If that were the case, then the icebergs would actually be yellow, not green. But if that yellow mixed with blue ice, then that would make green ice, as we all should know by now, and if you do, good for you for passing first grade. Yellow plus blue makes green. That's the end of my joke. According to a new paper, a team of glaciologists proposed the idea that these icebergs are turning green because they're serving up a crucial nutrient that supports almost all marine life. And that nutrient is iron oxides. According to the paper's lead author, Stephen Warren from the University of Washington, it's like taking a package to the post office. The iceberg can deliver this iron out into the ocean far away, then melt and deliver it to the phytoplankton and microscopic plants that can use it as a nutrient. Then the phytoplankton feeds the larger animals and it slowly goes up the food chain. Stephen Warren has been studying green icebergs since 1988. He wasn't all that surprised by the color of these bergs, or as we in Canada like to call them, dem bergs. He was actually more surprised about how dense they were. Unlike normal icebergs that are built from packed snow, the green ones don't have any air pockets, like no bubbles.
Bubbles?
No bubbles at all, which meant that these icebergs were special. After analyzing several of these bergs in the 1980s, Warren found out that the icebergs didn't break off of a glacier. Most icebergs break off and were actually once a part of glaciers. These icebergs were formed when frozen water clings to the underside of the Antarctic ice shelf. Then in 2016, Warren got a big lead on why these icebergs were turning green. A team of oceanographers led by Laura Boraguero from the University of Copenhagen tested an ice core taken from the Almery ice shelf in 1968. At the bottom of this core, they found that the ice contained 500 times more iron than the glacial ice above. Rocks from the Antarctic's mainland contains iron oxide. They are rustier, earthy in color. As glaciers form over bedrock, they will grind the rocks containing the iron oxides into a fine powder, which then finds its way into the sea. From there, it's believed that the iron oxide dust gets trapped under the ice shelf and then becomes a part of marine ice, which is what causes the emerald color. Iron oxide is actually very scarce in many parts of the ocean. It's believed that these green icebergs might be the only way that microscopic plants and phytoplankton can get their nutrients. Emerald green icebergs are an essential part of ocean ecosystems. And to answer the question everyone is thinking, no, you should not lick a green iceberg. Okay guys, that's all I have for you on this. I'm gonna wrap up this video with some comment features. J-Hope Hobie said, I asked last year and Charlotte did it, so I'm gonna ask again. Charlotte, March 9th is my birthday, can I get a happy birthday? Heck yeah, you can, woohoo! Happy birthday to one of our most loyal fans. Burned Ghost said, hi Inform Overload. Hi Burned Ghost. God said, this channel is really satisfying. Like, how satisfying? Like ASMR satisfying? Or like head scratch satisfying? I'm down to be satisfying. It's a good thing to be. Maha Muha said, Charlotte, I friggin' love your hoodie. Thank you very much. I friggin' love your screen name. Maha Muha. Okay, guys, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. If you want to keep watching, click on that playlist right over there. And if you enjoyed this video, you should leave a like, subscribe, and turn on those notifications so I can see you in a future IO video.